Hi, my name is James Berger. I'm a professor of biophysics at the Johns Hopkins School of Medicine, and we study biological nanomachines. Probably helpful to go right away to the toy box. Now we are interested in a couple of different kinds of machines that act on DNA. One of the kinds of machines actually is responsible literally for plowing apart DNA strands. So much like a snow plow would come along and move or split apart different parts of, say, would move snow away from itself. We would like to know how machines can use ATP to move along DNA strands and separate those two parts. In the realm of machines, my group has worked on a couple different types that do some pretty difficult mechanical kinds of manipulations to DNA. One is a machine that actually splits the strands in two. We've discovered that this machine is built like a ring, and one of those rings basically can encircle. So these are my DNA strands and they're twisted together. One of these rings can encircle the DNA, and then it uses ATP to pull it through, and in doing so, separates the strands. That's a machine called a helicase, and about 1% of the proteins inside your cells are helicases of one sort or another. So they're a very widespread and important class. The other kind of machine, though, that we've worked on actually comes in and unties this knot. And so what this machine does, literally, is it makes a crack in the DNA. It passes a second DNA strand through that crack, and then it reseals it. And at the end of this, you have two separated DNAs. This is important because if you don't untangle your DNAs when your cells go to divide, then the DNAs break. They shred. They get ripped apart. And that can give rise to not only DNA damage, but ultimately can set in motion a series of events that can lead to cancer predisposition. As it turns out, this DNA untangling or unknotting machine I just discussed is actually the target. It's called a topoisomerase. It's actually the target of a large number of different kinds of drugs. Here's one that's used in chemotherapy, and we determined how this particular molecule binds to and inhibits that enzyme, the topoisomerase, using structural biology, and that can hopefully go on to lead to better drugs or more improved drugs. But the other reason we do this is the same kind of reasons that we look up into the night sky, or that we embark on fantastically complicated ventures like building rocket ships and sending people to the moon. It's curiosity. We want to know what's out there. We want to know how it works. And the beautiful thing about basic research is that these kinds of endeavors lead to enormous payoffs and benefits down the road. And maybe there will be an application in the future. You just never know with basic science.